skip it up and that up.
What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? This is Rich of Review Tech USA, and this is why skinny jeans have become so popular. The game you were looking at today is Metro 2033. This is the PC version, but it is also available for the Xbox 360. And this is a fantastic game, but I will say one thing, or two things actually. One, you play it for the atmosphere. The shooter mechanics in it feel kind of dated. They're not that satisfying. And two, if you get it for the PC, you need to have a beefy rig. It was funny. Motherboard.org on YouTube just had a review of a 6 GB AMD Radeon card. Beefy, diesel, top-of-the-line card. And he tried to spread Metro 2033 across 3 monitors and an ultra-high resolution. You're thinking, okay, DirectX 11 game, but it's from 2009, earlier game, brand spanking new high-end video card. He should be able to use 3 monitors, no problem. He was getting like 10 frames a second with this game. So you need to have a diesel rig still to this day to play Metro 2033 on your PC. So I just read an interesting article on GameIndustry.biz where Jack Trenton defends the Vita and dedicated consoles. And to be honest, the reason I brought up this article is not to talk about the Vita, but to talk about something interesting he said in the article. Now I will say he defended the Vita, saying a lot of people are already counting it out because it's not selling gangbusters in the stores right now. But he said, a console is a long-term thing. You can't just judge it by what it sells in the first day of release. Which is true. He talked about how the PS3 was a complete disaster when it launched, and now it's a very popular console, which is 100% accurate. The PS3 was a disaster when it first launched, and Sony did turn it around. I have to commend them for that. But one statement that Jack made really struck a chord with me. I wanted to talk about this in an opinion video, and he pretty much said the same thing that I was thinking, and I'll read it to you now. I think the opportunity to be in the console business is greater than ever before. Social and free-to-play is a business I think a lot of companies are learning is difficult to sustain for the long term. It's an adjunct or it's an add-on, but it's not where gaming is headed. It's an additive diversion. There's a place for social and freemium, but it's not going to replace the business models that are out there. Now, one part of his statement I kind of don't agree with. I really think the next generation of consoles could be the last conventional generation of gaming consoles we will see. I'll have a video response posted below where I talk about this subject. But the other thing he says I do agree with. I think freemium gaming or free-to-play gaming will become more prevalent but won't take over conventional AAA games completely. I just don't think it will happen. The first thing is with free-to-play games, you're assuming that people will become so addicted to the game that they will make in-game microtransactions. What happens if some company like Epic Games comes out with a free-to-play game, and yeah, a lot of people are playing it, but they're not buying anything in the game. So therefore, Epic Games won't be making a profit. Whereas with a conventional game that you buy through Steam, where you go to GameStop and buy, you're giving money up front. The company got their pound of flesh from you. Whereas with free-to-play games, they're hoping that you'll buy something. And I don't think, like, say every developer out there went over to free-to-play, it would become a flooded market just like the AAA game market, and companies would still end up closing their doors. Because they'll realize the hard way that not every single developer can switch over to the free-to-play format and make a killing. Secondly, people are still going to want that AAA experience. Now, I know a lot of developers say, oh, we can give that with free-to-play. Look at Blacklight Retribution. Look at Tribes Ascend. We're giving you that AAA experience. I don't mean that. People still want their single-player campaign the way they have it now. People still want their epic storylines. People still want their engrossing adventures. And I'm not saying that free-to-play can't completely give that, but it's still a different animal, and not every gamer wants that kind of experience. I think what it really is, and the reason why free-to-play keeps coming up, is that AAA games right now aren't selling as well as they did a couple years ago. And there's a few reasons as to why. The first one is, and I say this over and over and over again in my videos, the global economy is still in shambles. People don't have money to buy every single game that comes out, so they only buy a couple or none at all and just wait for the games they really want. People rather keep their lights on than play a video game, because if you don't have electricity, you can't play video games anyway, so they'll skip out on buying every single AAA title. The second reason is because of sequelitis. Every game is a carbon copy of its predecessor or a carbon copy of another series, and people are losing their excitement and interest over game franchises that were blockbuster series a few years ago. So my message to developers is, because if you don't innovate, people will stop buying because they get bored, and we're seeing that right now. And last but not least, and this is a long shot, is that the Wii U is coming out. The Wii U is a symbol of the next generation, so people may be looking at their 360s and PS3s and thinking, next generation is right around the corner, so instead of keep on investing in this current generation, my PS3 or 360, I should save my pennies and get the Wii U or wait till the Xbox 720 or PS4 come out. That could be another reason console games aren't flying off the shelves at the moment. So the bottom line is, I agree with Jack. I think free-to-play gaming will be a part of the industry, but it won't take over the entire gaming industry. There will always be millions of people who want that action-packed AAA adventure. I just don't think we need to have as many AAA games being released each year. It's flooding the market, and that's why a lot of companies are hurting. So what's your take on what Jack had to say? Do you disagree with him and think that free-to-play games will take over the gaming industry? Or do you think there will always be a place for AAA games? Make sure to rate, comment, favorite, and subscribe. And if you have an interesting news story you would like me to discuss, private message me with a link to the article on YouTube. And if I use your news story, I will give you a shout out in the video and feature your YouTube channel in the description.